Here, boy. Another one.
It says his name is Bergelmir. I think Mother said he was the king of the giants?
Aye, that he was. And quite a bit more.
Looks like he had a lot of kids.
That, little brother, is what we call an understatement.
He's dead, but nobody killed him. Do giants die from old age?
They may, though it's rare among the legends.
Again with the death traps.
I'd have thought, brother. Why don't you let the lad carry me for a while?
And let you miss this? No.
You're enjoying this, aren't you? Time to do what you do, brother.
Leave them in peace.
Obviously not referring to us.
Focus up, boy.
Ruger!
Chain waits.
Ah, it's the other kind. Variety is so important. Truly, do you hate this part?
I know.
We're so close.
I, for one, never doubted.
Right. Until gods grow good.
Could be quite a wait.
Nah. They're just waiting for us.
Time to flip the temple.
Yes, sir.
Let's just agree to stop saying the temple. It's starting to sound normal.
An army of statues.
I don't think they're the kind that come to life, if that's what you're worried about. Tyr often said that in the world of PC envisioned, the only soldiers he'd need would be statues. Bless his heart, but the bugger did take himself rather seriously, didn't he? Brothers, I know what I promised, but in case this doesn't work, just remember, Tyr had good cause to create these obstacles. He's kept Jotunheim out of Odin's reach, but the world is hardly at peace.
No, but it's got hope. We're all working together now. We have unity. That's what the rune on the door to this place was telling us. We're on Tyr's path.
Lift with your legs, brother.
He knows.
Just trying to be helpful. Sir, I'll be quite happy to be on your side, brother. And we're not dead. That's a plus.
There, on the left. I think we can climb back up to the realm travel room from there.
A climb, you say?
Aye, by the statues.
See that, Mimir? Nobody can do all this alone. All these obstacles. They're just chances to prove we're the ones who can beat them. We may argue. Me and Father. You and Freya. Brock and Sindri. But when we all work together, we do make a good team. And that's Tyr's test. That's why we're gonna make it to Jotunheim.
Do you hear that, brother? Lad's found his equilibrium.
What does that mean?
He means you speak wisely, Atreus. And that is good to hear.
I guess the temple was made to be flipped.
Look, the tree's upside down. Or are we? I'm not sure anymore.
Boy, your knife.
Well, what have we got?
Some sort of travel stone.
Let me see. Great are Dumbledore's. That's the Unity Stone.
You know it.
I wasn't sure it existed. If Tyr possessed this, that explains how he could visit all the realms and other lands to boot.
He held this in the panel in Odin's library.
Yes. Yes, that's it. I understand now. It shows Tyr walking the realm between realms. You know how you must never stray from the path. Well, Tyr always followed his own path, if you catch my meaning.
The realm between realms.
So you're saying Tyr's shrine showed him stepping off the branch of the world tree. And you're thinking, to reach the secret path to Jotunheim, that's what we need to do?
I am.
Oh dear. That is what you're thinking, isn't it?
Good. I am more than okay to throw ourselves over the edge of the world tree just yet.
In due time, boy.
Really?
Best work yet. Just need a little help from you lot.
What do you want?
With the whetstone and hammer you've retrieved for us, Brock and I can construct the Dvegrathikr, dwarven armor of legend.
We just need three more mythical ingredients before we set to hammer.
Which are?
Dunno. Armor's pure legend, and the details is fuzzier than a wolver's butthole.
you expect us to find parts from a legend?
Oh, Mozognir the Dwarf King found two of them. Everyone knows that. But when he went looking for the third...
Poof! He vanished. Maybe he'll find some clues at his stronghold in Konungsgard.
And looky here. A Konungsgard entry stone. It's got your name on it. How fucking strange. The stronghold's northwest of here, behind the Svartalfheim Realm Tower.
Large stone structure, creepy atmosphere. You'll know it when you see it.
I'm glad Brock and Sindri were able to work out their differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Ah, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again. Mimir, you never told us what Magni and Modi had to do with Hrungnir.
Oh, yes. Well, what happened after Hrungnir fell slain upon Thor was that nobody in the court could get the stone body off of him. Thor was no use at this point, his brain rattled, his breath shallow, but none of Odin's men were nearly strong enough to help. Then enter little Magni and Modi, no taller than shrubs. And while nobody but myself was looking, they flipped over Hrungnir's corpse and freed their father. Magni, being blonder, got all the credit, and Modi remained bitter about it from that day to the end. Which I don't need to tell you about.
Mimir, why did you work for Odin if he's so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to make your career as a counselor to kings, you can't very well rule out petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cruel piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows, they called us. Knavish sprites to the last. We'd get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of the local mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. And one day he was not amused. And I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads travelled since then have turned me from that merry wanderer into the paragon of virtue you see before you today.
Amir, how'd you come to be in these lands?
Lad, there comes a time in every man's life when he changes his name and heads north to make a new start. If you live long enough to do this many times over, you might end up as far north as this place. By the time I arrived, I already knew Odin by his reputation, and so I set to demonstrate my worth by coming to him with something I knew he'd value, a mystic well of knowledge. Or rather, I should say, a well of water laced with enough mystic mushrooms to make a god see visions. Oh, he was rightly impressed. Can't say for sure what he saw that led him to try gouging out his own eyes, but I managed to restrain him before he finished the job. Then I persuaded him it has been his sacrifice made for an even higher form of sight to be bestowed. Blah, 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 blah. I used to think he never caught on. But the day he took my eye, I realized he had never been fooled. He knew I'd outwitted him, called the lesson wisdom, and hired me to make sure from then on I was on his side. And for a long, long time, I truly was. Doesn't mean he didn't hold a grudge.
Mimir, I still don't get why you ever wanted to work for Odin.
Back then, I was young enough to still be ambitious. The Aesir gods were as powerful a force as I'd come across, but they clearly lacked for strategy, focus, and sage counsel. All this could I faithfully provide. And so, a stranger from a far-off island found himself with Odin's ear, trusted as he trusted no one but himself. And with that kind of power, laddie, I must confess, there are perks.
Yeah, but he's Odin.
I never claim to be perfect, laddie, only clever. And often too clever by half.
So what'd you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Well, for a long time my job was to enable Odin, and I was fucking excellent at it. Gradually, as I grew more to care about people and the world, my job became to contain him, to protect him from himself. By serving peace, I served his interests as well. That's the truth. But he saw it as disloyalty. No longer trusting my motives, but not wishing to part with my brain or tongue, he bound me to a tree and adopted a new pastime of casual torture.
Well, I'm glad we came along to cut off your head.
Aye, lad. Lucky break that was.
Be our best work yet. Just need a little help from you lot.
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a...
Come, boy.
Coming.
If I'm not mistaken, we've yet to discuss the tale of the giant Bergelmir.
Oh yeah, I remember his shrine. It looked happier than the other ones, mostly.
It begins in an ocean of blood.
Finally, a story worth hearing.
If you remember, Ymir, the first giant, was fatally stabbed by Odin. It's in his blood our story starts. Ymir's magical guts poured out in a torrent so violent it threatened to flood all of creation. The Jotnar were unprepared, as the very last of them were washed away in the endless tide. Not just Ymir, but all of giant kind faced extinction. And so would Odin's victory have been complete. But Ymir's kind did not all perish that day. Staying afloat in the hollowed husk of a tree, the frost giant Bergelmir endured, as did his lady wife. For weeks they sailed, until finally they came upon a new land. They called it Jotunheim. And there they would start anew. As father and mother, they would multiply exceedingly, and as king and queen, they worked to make Jotunheim a land where giants would know no master but themselves. Bergelmir never sought revenge for Odin's slaughter. His vengeance was to live and prosper. He died at peace, a legion of his kin to mourn him. He will ever be known as Bergelmir the Beloved.
Bergelmir the Beloved. Huh. I've never heard a story end that way. Not a true one, anyway.
You do, laddie.
Here, boy.
It says, glory to Mjolnir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to... I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various... sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Whoa. Another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Nicely done.
If the Dwarf King captured more than one dragon, he must have needed them to create this legendary army.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Potently powerful.
The head is having fun with you.
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
done. Yourself, boy.